Welcome to Rockline on MTV, where you get to talk to your favorite artists live. Our toll-free number is 1-800-344-ROCK, and that's 344-7625. If your call gets on the air, you will receive a box of 10 Sony UX Turbo audio tapes, and they are designed to stand the heat of your car's interior, even on a hot summer day, only from Sony Recording Media. My guest today, we'd like to welcome to the Rockline studio, Mr. Weird Al Yankovic.
Oh, hi, Martha.
Hi, Al.
Doing? It's been so long.
Ouch!
Good to see you.
How dare you?
I'm
How
sorry.
Dare you grab my leg?
I'm sorry.
I have a secret.
What? What? Give it.
Smells Like Nirvana video has been added in. Video has been in the top three on MTV's Most Wanted ever since it was released. The album, Off the Deep End, number 22 on the Billboard charts. Weird Al Yankovic, how do you do it?
I amaze myself. I boggle my mind.
No, really.
Well, thanks for noticing, Martha. You did your research, and that's good. That's a good attribute.
Well, thank you. Back to my question. How do you do it?
How do I do it?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little payola here or there. You know, it greases the charts. No, just kidding.
Every MTV executive is going, oh, God, why did he say that?
How do I do it?
Aren't you so happy?
I am happy.
You should be.
I'm just a wacky, zany, noofy, nutty, goofy, zany. I'm a noofy kind of guy.
Noofy.
Just like you. You're kind of noofy in your own way.
I'm a noofy gal.
You are.
Well, what do you say we invite some other noofs to take part?
Well, fine.
Okay, Jeff, how are you today? Feeling noofy?
Pretty noofy.
Good. Out there in Walkersville, Maryland, say hello to Weird Al Yankovic.
Hi,
hey,
Jeff.
How you doing?
Good. That rumor about the gerbil, it's a lie. I deny it all. What can I do for you?
Kind of a conversation stuff for there,
I was wondering if there was any particular point in your life when you decided to pursue this line of work, or if you've always wanted to do this.
What, talk with Martha on TV?
You've always wanted to do that.
I've always wanted to do that. It's lifelong ambition. It's just something that I've done since I was an embryo, pretty much. In my early teens, I would send in tapes to Dr. Demento, and he gave me airplay at an early age, and just kind of gradually became Weird Al full time, I guess.
The Dr. Demento
show. Yeah.
Is that show still on the air?
I think it is. Absolutely. Yeah, he celebrated his 20th anniversary on the air last year, so he's been around a while.
Wow. So he really gave you your first big break.
Yeah,
Dr.
he's always
Demento.
Been my D-mentor.
Your D-mentor.
Oh, stop me. Oh, I'm much better now.
You've never said that before.
No. That's not a stock answer at all.
Jeff, thank you very much for your call, and we're going to move over to Pittsburgh, PA, where Mark is on the line waiting to say hello to you, Al.
Me? Hi, Mark.
Hello?
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 Turn down your radio. Turn down your radio.
It is down.
Oh, good. What can I do for you?
How'd you get the nickname Weird?
Gee, I can't imagine.
Nobody's ever asked me that before. That's so amazing.
Now, Al,
now
not
Martha.
Everybody knows.
Well,
in fact, I don't know.
I don't know why they... Why do you think they call me Weird? Just...
Gosh, Al, I wouldn't have
amazing.
A clue.
It's actually a nickname I picked up in college because I did the Weird Al show every Saturday night on my college campus radio station, and it just kind of stuck for some reason.
So you gave yourself that name?
I guess I did.
Well.
Silly me.
Thanks, Mark. And we've got Mitch calling from Carthage, Illinois. Mitch, take your chances with Weird Al.
Mitch!
Hi, Al. How do you pick out a person to parody?
Oh, you know, I pick out somebody that's, you know, fairly popular, like somebody along the lines of a Michael Jackson or Madonna or Nirvana or something like that. It makes more sense to do that than a Pancreas Joe and the Eskimo Leftists, I think, because MTV doesn't play too much of them.
Mm. Mitch, did that really answer your question?
Did that make any sense at all? Am
now,
I babbling?
Do people,
should I go home now?
Do people come up to you all the time and go, hey, Al, wait, I know, you know that song, Palgate, you should do Ground Snake. That'd be so funny, and give you, like, suggestions.
Yeah, I get hundreds of letters in the mail every week. Al, I got a parody of Thrillers called Griller. No, Chiller. No, Phyllis Diller. No, Miller.
Yeah, Griller, where they chop up dead bodies
yeah,
and put
yeah,
it on
yeah.
the grill.
Yeah, that'd be great. You got to do that.
Or when, I imagine, when you first heard Right Said Fred, if you were sitting in a room full of people, if everybody in the room just went.
Well, some people are a little hard to make fun of because they're be a little redundant, let's say.
Not necessarily Right Said
Fred. No, not necessarily them, just because you happen to mention them prior to me saying
it's
that.
Just an example.
Yeah.
Al, we're
we're just doing a little, we're like playing tennis here, aren't we? Woo! So we got Brahm on the line from
Brahm!
New Paltz, New York.
It's
okay.
Been so long.
Okay.
What's up,
Deep
pal?
Breath. Calm for Brahm. Brahm?
Brahm,
go
we're
ahead.
Calm.
What's up, pal?
How you doing, Brahm? You never call, you never write.
Was Nirvana upset with you for using their song? And how old are you, Martha?
Brahm, I hate your guts.
You want to answer the second question
Brahm,
first, or should you just
let me explain? Brahm helped us test out the calls, and I was talking about it's my birthday next Monday, and I told Brahm how old I was, and I said, Brahm, you ask how old I am. I'm going to kill you, and I know where you live, Brahm, so don't leave your house.
But she looks great for early 40s, doesn't she?
Okay, we're moving on. We're going to take a break. We're going to cut the show off at this point. No, Brahm, what's your question?
Oh,
I'll allow you.
I remember. I go way back. No, the guys in Nirvana were very cool about it. I called up Kurt Cobain when they were doing Saturday Night Live, and I called him and said, hi, it's Weird Al Yankovic, and I want to know if I can do a parody of Smells Like Teen Spirit. And he said, yeah, sure, that'd be cool. Is it going to be another song about food? And I said, no, it's going to be about how nobody can understand your lyrics. And he goes, oh, that's pretty funny. Go ahead. And they're very cool about it.
It is so funny.
Thank you.
When you saw it, did you just know? Did you have a feeling?
I had a gut feeling.
Now,
from way down deep.
Really?
Really, Martha.
Like here, here?
Well, it kind of started here and then kind of moved over to the side a little
kind
bit.
Kind of like a rash.
Yeah.
Anyway, Brahm, I didn't mean to skirt your question. I'm 24. And now we have Michelle on the line from Wrightsville, Pennsylvania. Hi, Michelle. What's your question for Al?
Hi, Martha. Hi, Al.
Hi.
My questions are, when's your birthday? And why haven't you done a parody of a New Kids song yet?
Actually.
Okay.
Let's talk about the new CD.
Okay.
In which there is...
Which there is, in fact,
a
parody of the
You Got the Right Stuff, which we call the white stuff.
Which is about the filling in Oreo cookies, of course.
Scotty Brothers CD, Off the Deep End.
That's great, because I'm a really big New Kids fan, so, and an Al fan.
Well, you should rush right out into buying frenzy then. And by the way, it's October 23rd.
That's 8 days before mine. I was born
no
October
way.
31st.
So wait, you are both, wait, don't, do not tell me, you are both Scorpios?
Multicellular life forms.
Yes, we're both Scorpios.
Oh, you Scorpios.
Actually, I'm a cusp kind of person myself, but.
Okay, we're going to take a break, drink massive amounts of chamomile tea or something. Our toll-free number is 1-800-344-ROCK. That's 344-7625. Our guest today is Weird Al Yankovic.
When I'm going to the movies, I take up seven rows because I'm fat,
fat. Welcome back, Rockline on MTV. My guest today is Weird Al. If you have a question, the number is, and it's toll-free, 1-800-344-ROCK. That video that we just saw in the top three, the most wanted every day since it has been added.
Just cracks me right up.
And we have you in the flesh to talk to you. Find
yeah,
out what's...
Martha, I'm so glad to be here with you. I can't tell. We go back so... You know, can I just give you something for as a memento? I've got something for you in my pants. If you don't...
Stop it.
There's something to remember our time together.
Jeez. I shudder to think what this was rubbing up against. Well, these are very nice. Isn't
I'm shuddering
sweet?
Too. Oh.
Kind of like a birthday present.
Yeah. How old are you anyway?
Okay, so thanks a lot, Al. We have a question from Edina, Minnesota. Chris is calling from Edina. Chris, what's your question today?
Yeah, Weird Al. When are you going on world tour?
When am I going on world tour?
Yeah.
I'm leaving later this month and probably playing at a Edina near you.
Cool.
So you're touring
We're
the
touring
country?
With my band and doing a multimedia extravaganza all around the United States and Canada and like that.
What do you mean a multimedia extravaganza?
Oh, it's hard to describe. You know, it's like a live band performance and film clips and costume changes. And it's like a Prince concert, except it's intentionally funny.
Thank you, Chris, for your call.
Thanks, Chris.
And now,
okay, one thing.
Chris, is this still you?
You probably know my dad, Grant Swain.
Oh, yeah.
No, me?
You did Greyhound.
Are you talking to me, Chris?
Yeah.
You know, that's funny. I called. called your father just today. That's so funny. Yes, I did. Well, nice to meet you, Chris. I hope you enjoy Minneapolis. Okay, bye. We'll just chat amongst ourselves for a while. And we'll move over to Syracuse, New York, where Dusty is on the line waiting to say hello to the weird one himself. Hey, Dusty, what's your question?
How you doing? This is Dusty from 104.7. Me and the station manager, Brad.
Is this on the air?
We were wondering where Weird Al got his sense of humor from, the Rick of San.
I got it all from Martha. She made me everything I am today. Martha, thank you so much.
You're welcome, Al. And we've got Nick on the line from Rochester Hills, Mish. Nick?
Hi.
Hello.
Man, this is an honor. It's a true honor.
And for
thank
me, too.
Thank you. And Al's here, too.
Okay. Have you ever tried to parody a song and the original artist wouldn't let you do it?
That happens very infrequently. Most artists have a good sense of humor and they realize it's not a put-down, it's not meant to make them look bad, it's not derogatory, and they accept it as a tribute.
But what about the artists who don't?
They don't accept it as a tribute.
Like, for instance?
Well, hell, this Prince never let me do anything, but that kind of surprised me because, you know, I'd always heard that midgets have a pretty good sense of humor, so I...
Now I understand the Like a Prince concert, but intentionally funny. I see. I think we tapped into a little nerve here.
Bitter? No, I'm fine. Thank you for asking.
Never bitter, only better. Thank you, Nick. Arlington, Texas, we have Jeff on the line. Jeff, what is on your mind today?
Hey, Al, my shorts.
Why, thank you, Jeff. And I like your shoes.
I just want to know... Why do you wear all these Hawaiian t-shirts?
I don't know. It's something I've done for many years. It's just kind of a look, I guess. That's all I have in my closets, pretty much, because one tour I did, as a perk, I asked the promoters to include one Hawaiian shirt with every show that I did. It's kind of like the Van Halen version of the brown M&Ms or whatever. And as a result, I wound up with closets full of Hawaiian shirts, and I just have a lot of them.
You know... The mood that you create is sort of, it's catching. It's like, I feel like I'm in the Crazy Eddie commercial, like, it's insane.
Are you feeling kind of loopy right now?
Ow,
hey.
Let's go.
Okay, any more radio stations calling up? Okay.
So let me try and search for my own identity for a moment. I know it's
be
in
yourself.
There.
Be yourself. Go with
I'll
the feeling.
I'll try. It's very hard. Very hard for me to do that. We're going to go to Ashland, Massachusetts, where we will speak with Julie. Hey, Julie, what's up?
Hi, nothing.
Nothing.
Hi,
sad.
I was wondering, do you plan on doing any more movies?
Why, Julie, you know, I'd like to. I really
would.
Wait,
I'll talk normally for a minute.
Well, Julie, you know, I'd really like to. There's nothing in the works right now, but hopefully after the concert tour, after the dust settles, we'll, you know, think about doing, you know, UHF 2, 3, 4, and 5, or whatever else comes along.
Thank you, Julie.
Thanks, Julie.
See, and you, it was kind of a struggle to just...
It was.
Drop
I had
that.
To dig deep and find my real inner self.
Well, that's what we want to do here.
Are you digging deep?
Yeah.
How dare you?
Okay, we have Richard on the line from Hurricane, West Virginia. Richard, you have a question?
Yeah, I was going to ask you, Al, where did you get the idea for Nature Trail to Hell in 3D, I might add?
Oh, that was...
I don't even know what that is.
It's an obscure original song that I did years and years ago on my second album. Where did I get the idea for that? That was inspired by all the gore movies that were coming out at the time, like, you know, Friday the 13th Part 12 or whatever. And in fact, that is the only song of mine that has backwards masking on it. If you play it backwards, you can hear Satan Eats Cheese Whiz. So...
A little insight.
Yeah.
Okay, you're watching Rockline on MTV. We're going to be taking a break. Our guest today, Weird Al Yankovic, and we will be right back.
You better chow down, or it's going to get cold, so eat it. I don't care if you're full, just eat it. Eat it.
It cooks.
Like a surgeon, here's a waiver for you to.
Whoa. Welcome back. It's Rockline on MTV. If you have a question for Weird Al, our number is, and it's toll-free, 1-800-344-ROCK. That's 344-7625. If your call gets on the air, you will receive a box of 10 Sony UX Turbo audio tapes designed to stand the heat of your car's interior, even on a hot summer day, and that's only from Sony Recording Media. And I should mention that right after this Rockline, the Best of Weird Al is going to be airing. It's the hour version.
Best of Al TV, you mean?
Best
I knew
of
what
Al
you
TV.
Meant, because yeah. You know we have this connection here.
And I appreciate that. And Thursday morning, what am I thinking?
You're thinking all 3 hours of Al TV are going to air again from 9 to 12.
You read my mind. That's so
amazing.
Incredible. We work together like Bob and Ray, like Sid and Nancy. Okay, let's take some calls. This is our last segment, so we're going to burn right through.
Okay, we're
we
burning.
Have Tim calling from Kissimmee, Florida. Hey, Tim, how are you?
Hi. Hi, Weird Al.
Hi, Tim.
Yeah. I was wondering, what was your first song parody?
Oh, the first one that ever made it onto... Oh, Martha, take this one.
I have a guess.
Okay.
I think it's Maya Bologna.
Very good. 10 points. Ding, ding, ding.
So, Tim, since I stole your question, do you have another one?
Not really.
Oh, thanks a lot, Martha.
I'm sorry.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, we're going to go on to Monroe, and I won't answer this time. We'll let you answer a question.
Okay.
From Livingston, New Jersey. Hi, Monroe.
What up, Almeister? Hi, Martha. I have two questions for you, Al.
Okay.
All right. First of all, the guitarist and drummer in your video smells like Nirvana.
Uh-huh.
Are they going on tour with you?
The same guys. They look a little different. They were both wearing wigs for the video, but they're the same guys that have been with me since day one.
Okay. And my second question, when you put the wig on for Smells Like Nirvana, did you have to cut your bush off?
Cut my what?
Bush.
I think he means maybe your hair.
Oh, okay.
No,
that was actually, my hair actually had to be straightened and then slicked back into like a hard little helmet. So it was difficult getting the wig on, but we did it, yeah.
Thank you, Monroe. We've got Kevin calling, Augusta, Georgia on the line. Kevin, go for it.
Hi, Al.
Hi, Kevin.
Yeah, you plan on doing stand-up comedy soon?
No, I get too tired. I like just like sit down, you know, or crouch. Crouching's good too.
Do you ever do stand-up comedy?
Not really, no. But thanks for asking.
Do you ever do club dates or anything like that?
I mean, if we do club dates, they're usually larger clubs, and then we're playing, you know, with the band. But, you know, stand-up comedy kind of frightens me because it's difficult for me to think on my feet because all the blood rushes down, you know. It's difficult.
Do you know, I did stand-up comedy at the Improv for about 10 minutes. It was so horrifying. I never did it again. It was so horrifying.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. Kevin, thank you. We have Bobby on the line, who's calling from Front Royal, Virginia. Bobby, how are you?
All right. Hi, Rodell.
Hi, Bobby.
My question is, when's your next video coming out?
I don't know, but you'll be the first person I call and tell. I promise.
Do you know what your next video is going to be?
I really don't. I honestly, truly don't.
And you do.
I would tell you if I knew.
Okay, Bobby, thank you. It was a good question, though. And we have Scott, who's calling from St. Louis, Missouri. Scott, care to say hello to Weird Al and ask a question?
Hi, Mr. Al.
Mr. Al.
Ooh, hi, Mr. Scott.
Yeah. I was wanting to know, is there a Mrs. Weird?
No, I hope not.
A Mrs. Weird.
No, my accordion is still my main squeeze.
Oh! But seriously, folks, and you say you can't think on your feet.
Well, I'm sitting down.
Oh, that's true. You really can't. Scott, thank you. We have a question coming from College Station.
I'm next.
What? Oh, Chris. Chris is like, hey, dudes, I'm next. Chris, you're on, buddy. Chris.
Hey, Chris.
Turn down your TV.
Chris!
Chris. Oh, God.
Oh, Chris. You're trapped.
Weird. Huh? May I call you Weird?
No. Well, you can. You're the only one.
I got two questions. What is your meaning of life? And...
Okay, let's just start with that. How about that? We'll all take a deep breath. Answer
okay.
that. What is your meaning of life?
Life is a bowl of three-legged salamanders swimming around in an infinite ocean of boysenberry yogurt. Does that answer your question? Hello? Hello?
Okay, thank you, Chris.
You see, it takes a while to think about that. Yeah, it has to let it soak in.
He was excited to talk to you.
He was becoming one with the universe.
There you go. And we have Charlie calling from Monroe, Louisiana. Charlie,
hello.
Go ahead.
Hi, Charlie.
Yeah, I needed to know. First of all, Martha, my roommate Billy thinks you are beautiful.
Oh.
And I have to tell you that. Second of all, Al, I want to know if you have any TV appearances planned in the near future, and if so, when?
Well, Weird.
The best
Al TV. Just stay tuned. I'll be on for the rest of the month.
And then Thursday morning,
Thursday morning, 9 to 12. See if you're paying attention now. Oh, well, these kids today, they never listen.
Thanks, Charlie. Glad you have your MTV back down there in College Station, Texas. And we have Gary calling from Watertown, Connecticut. Hi, Gary.
Hey,
come on
what's
on.
Up?
And
hey, Gary.
You know, believe it or not, you're my biggest hero. And I just have to know, when did you start
Gandhi,
playing the accordion?
Gandhi, Kennedy, nothing to him. It's Weird Al. Gary, go ahead. What was your question?
I'm sorry.
Well, when did you start playing the accordion?
When I was about 7 years old, and haven't put it down since. It's become a part of me. Well,
well,
not attached,
they're
but.
Counting me down. I've got 5, 4. That's it for this edition.
No!
I know, it goes quick. Next week on Vogue will be here, so join us. Thank you so much. Wow. See, I got the 5 seconds, and now it's Best of Al coming up. It's just a wacky adventure coming up.